Hey guys, welcome to section 1.6, where today we're going to be talking about how to use linear regression and generally just fit linear functions to different types of data. So without further ado, let's take a look at our first example, okay? It says the data points from a crankcase motor oil producing company are listed below in the table below. They want to study the correlation between the number of minutes of TV ads per day for their product and the total number of oil cases sold per month, okay? So what they found is that if there is 1 minute per day of TV ads, then they would sell 1 million units over the course of a month. On the other hand, if there were two, it would take us up to 2.5 and so on and so forth, such that by the time we get to 6.2 ads minutes per day of ads, they were actually selling almost nine times what they were down here at just 1 minute per day, okay? So down below, we see that there is actually a scatter plot of this data, 1, 1, 2, 2.5, so on and so forth. And again, they just set up their X and Y axes. What we're going to be doing is actually coming up with what we refer to as the regression line, otherwise known as the line of best fit, okay? So this is really just gonna be the optimum linear function that describes the data. And I do wanna point out, obviously, there are different types of functions that could work here, right? Depending on how you see this, depending on the approach you're gonna use, this could be parabolic, right? Meaning degree two. It could be cubic, degree three, quartic, degree four, so on and so forth. It could behave, in fact, like an exponential function, where the degree isn't set, but indeed increases as your inputs increase. Or it could be logarithmic in value, okay? There are just so many different methods that could work here. And right now, of course, in unit one, we're still dealing with lines, and lines are best fit. So let's try to just set this up using, our calculator and a line of best fit. So first of all, we need to know how to actually enter this data in our calculator. So if you guys could go ahead and get those ready. Pardon me. If you could go ahead and, first of all, we need to all go to mode, and there's one particular feature that's going to benefit us later on, and really that has to do with our stat diagnostics. So if I come up here, we want to turn our stat diagnostics on, okay? Now, depending on the type of calculator, that may not even be necessary. Some of them may already go ahead and show you our R value, but on the TI-84 CE, this is how we guarantee that it will work, that it will do that, okay? So make sure that's turned on. Again, that was just mode, scroll on up, and now we'll quit out, okay? The second piece would be just how do we enter our data in the first place? So there's a button here named stat, and if I just go straight to edit, stat one or stat enter, it will take me to my lists, okay? Now you gotta realize that these are supposed to be basically lists of elements, right? They make sets. So based on this, you know, data up above, we should be able to set up each list as one of our two variables. So generally speaking, you will want your inputs, in this case is our X value, to be L1, because the standard for setting up your stats and doing regression and all that is such that L1 will always serve as the input, okay? So that's why I would always recommend that here. So let's quickly enter those. 1, 2, 3, 3.5, 5.5, and 6.2. And of course, between each one of those, I'm just hitting enter so that it will allow me to go to the next element in the set. Let's do the same thing with our outputs. We get a 1, a 2.5, a 3.7, a 4.2, a 7, and an 8.7. And now we have them set up, right? So we have list one, we have list two, and I want to show you what this would look like. If all we had were lists, we actually need to go to this stat plot feature, okay? So down below here, you guys will notice we have the stat plot right above y equals. First of all, everybody just hit y equals and make sure that those are cleared out. We don't want old functions. Just like when we're plotting functions, we don't want old stat plots. In fact, that's one of the common errors when we go back, is people leave their plots on and go, why is it telling me error? Different types of restrictions. So just make sure this is canceled. And then of course, when we're done here, we need to turn those back off. So you could go up and just hit enter, but you don't really know what plot one is talking about yet. So let's go second y equals, and that'll take me to my stat plot feature, okay? So here we go. Plot one is designated as list one, list two, which is perfect. Like I said, that should be the standard for everybody. If I just hit enter there, it'll take me, and I could adjust these. Okay, you can adjust those by changing the list value. Okay, you could hit second stat, or down below, I could hit second one, which would be L1, or second two, which would be L2, or you know, so on and so forth. They actually have the six lists here. And in that way, you could look at lots of stat plots simultaneously with different colors, okay, allowing you to differentiate all on the same graph. So X list is L1, Y list is L2. I always like just the dots here, okay? So I would go on over, but it's really your call what you want them to be denoted by. This is also just a scatter plot, but there are different ways to approach these. I mean, box and whisker, histogram, whatever. So let's just go ahead and keep it simple. And this color will be blue. You can, again, change that to whatever you want, okay? Now, if I just hit graph, chances are good that most of us are in Zoom standard. So let's hit zoom, and instead of standard, I want everybody to look down here at 9, or again, other calculators may have something else there, but for me, 9 will allow me to zoom in specifically on my data. I just realized I didn't turn my stat plot on, so why don't we actually do that? Second stat plot, enter, on. There we go. And now if I hit zoom 9, zoom stat, it'll hone in specifically on the values best suited to looking at our data. We got a 1.1 here all the way up to a 6.2, 8.7, right? And of course, if you look at your window, you'll notice it does pretty much mimic that in easy ways for us to tell. Pardon me. Okay, so we got our graph down, but we're looking for the line of best fit. So let's talk about the second piece here, okay? You actually don't need to look at this without the line of best fit, but I wanted you all to see what that would look like, okay? Let's hit stat, and this time we're gonna hit right and go over to calculate. And what you're gonna notice here are there are lots of different options. We have linear regression, quadratic regression, cubic, quartic, I mean, so on and so forth. And in fact, another type of linear where the first term is your initial value and the second will then be your slope times your y-intercept, right? They call it A and B, but we know that to be M and B. And in this case, that would be B plus M, okay? They're just defining it in a slightly different way, in the same way that on our applied problems, we talked about how we could reverse our terms, right? So there's natural logarithmic regression, there's exponential regression, there are loads of options available here, okay? All we really want right now is our first method known as linear regression, okay? So an AX plus B. We do want our X's to be L1, we want our Y's to be L2, and again, if you ever wanted to change those, you could just hit second, like 5 would be list 5, or second 6 would be list 6, so on and so forth. We don't need to worry about a frequency list. That really has to do with more stat options where you guys would be plugging in, again, lots more data at the same locations. And that way it will weight that that input-output pair more heavily for the sake of your regression, okay? And finally, store the regression equation. We do want to do this so that I don't have to like type it all in. There's a nice way to go about this. I want to store it in my y equals list. It's about to come up with a line in the form AX, Y equals AX plus B. So if I hit variables and go right one, you'll notice it says Y variables function. Hit enter. And now I can store this as Y1 in my Y list. Now before we go anywhere, hit calculate, enter. And you will see all these nasty looking decimals, right? Well, it just went through a process known as least squares regression. Okay, that's the method that all these calculators use in order to come up with a line of best fit by some sort of criteria. And there are different criteria to do that. But in this case, it's telling us our slope is about 1.42. Our initial value would be about negative 0.5. And then I want everybody just to look at the R value. This is what we know as our correlation coefficient. We're going to define that more clearly here in just a little bit, okay? So our R value is 0.99556, etc. This is a very strong positive correlation. And again, we'll talk about what that means. This equation, y equals 1.42x minus 0.51 or so, is now stored in our y equals. If I go there, you'll notice the nasty looking decimals have already been entered, okay? Even all the way over, here's your y-intercept, all because you already entered it, and that way you don't have to worry about trying to write it down and then copy it on over yourself. Let's just hit graph. And there you have it. So we now have our line of best fit, okay? Obviously, I talked to you guys through every little detail. This can be much faster if that wasn't the case. So it's not all that hard a process to go through, but it is one that you guys need to practice because on quizzes and tests, if the skill isn't in place, it will take you much longer. And also, I can't help you by reminding you how to do it. That is part of what we're testing on. So make sure that you guys can do that yourself. If that means rewatching that section of notes, please do so, okay? We will pick up the notes here in video 2. So I'll see you there.